we have been coordinating the whole operation together with our Italian colleagues. Until now, there are at least 30 people who we have can see who are dead and who have been brought on our patrol boats. Around 150 are being brought back to Malta, and another 60 being taken to Italy for medical for medical help. What I can say, your correspondent said that right now politicians are thinking about tightening or loosening migration rules. In our case, our main concern is rescuing these people at sea, and we feel abandoned by Europe. We feel abandoned like no other day today. I don't know how many more people need to die at sea before something gets done. And we will make sure that our voice is heard during the next European Council, both ourselves and the Italians, to say that rules need to change. Whether they are tighter or looser, it doesn't really make, it's not the issue. It's the fact is that this thing is broken and it needs to be fixed.
Well, how can it be fixed? Because critics argue that if you tighten legislation, then you are basically helping out people who traffic these people who are in desperate situations, who want to get out. As our correspondent was saying, some from Syria, some from these places within the Middle East where there is turbulence there. How do you make sure that they don't suffer these horrific situations?
Yes, I have nothing against loosening up the rules. The fact is that as things stand, we're just building a cemetery within our Mediterranean Sea. We have solutions. We have proposed solutions. First of all, changing the rules that govern all this sector, namely the Dublin II regulation, increasing international development aid, increasing the patrols in order to rescue people at sea, and definitely roping in countries such as Libya as active partners within all these operations. Until now, we have encountered statements, words, but little more than that.